Today, let's talk about how to encrypt a file or folder using Windows File Encryption, which comes with your operating system. First, open File Explorer and find the documents or folder you want to encrypt. Right-click on the document or folder and choose Properties. At the Properties pop-up window, choose Advanced. To encrypt, choose Encrypt Contents to Secure Data, and then choose OK. This will bring you back to the Properties window where you choose Apply. You get an encryption warning at this point, and you can choose to encrypt just the file or the file in its parent folder. When you have made your selection, choose OK. This brings you back to the Properties window where you also choose OK. Note that there is a yellow lock on your document now, meaning that it is encrypted. One thing to note, if you email this document, the encryption does not seem to stick. However, if you move this document to a thumb drive or laptop, you will need the decrypt key to access it. Now, it is very important to create the recovery key and store it in a safe place, not on your computer. Think about, what if my hard drive fails on my primary computer and I need to recover the files? If the recovery key is also on the hard drive, it may be impossible. Also, never store the recovery key in the same place as your encrypted files. It's like providing the key to your car when the thief is looking in the window trying to steal it. So, to create the recovery key, go back to your file, right-click, and choose Properties again. In the Properties window, choose Advanced again, and on the Advanced Attributes window, choose Details. Now, if you right-click on a folder that you've encrypted, this won't work. You have to click on a file within the folder. Highlight the user that has the certificate tied to their name, and the Backup Keys button will activate. Choose Backup Keys. This brings you to the Certificate Export Wizard. Choose Next on the Welcome screen. Then choose Next on the Export File Format screen, noting the default selections for Personal Information Exchange. Now enter your password for your recovery key. Make sure it's a good, long, hard-to-guess password and don't lose it. Follow good password hygiene and don't reuse passwords. Choose Next. Browse for where you would like to store your certificate recovery key and name it. Note that when you name your recovery key, don't name it recovery key. Follow the security by obscurity rule and name it something that is not obvious. When you choose Finish, the wizard tells you the export was successful. So then choose OK. Now close out of the other windows by choosing OK. Make sure you back up this file in multiple places because if you lose it, you will not be able to recover your encrypted files. So, now let's say you're traveling and you need to take your sensitive files with you on a laptop. Here you can see that we have copied the encrypted file to a thumb drive. You can't open the encrypted document on your laptop until you have installed the recovery key. So, take a copy of your recovery key to your laptop to install it. Here we have copied the recovery key to a folder called Demo. Next, right-click on the key and choose Install PFX. This brings you to the Certificate Import Wizard. The default is Current User, which means that the decryption will only work for the user you are signed in as when you install the recovery key. If you want anyone to be able to use it that has access to your machine, then choose Local Machine. Choose Next. On the second Certificate Import Wizard screen, browse for the recovery key. If you will remember, we had stored this in our Demo folder. Choose Next. Now you must enter the password to install the recovery key. Note that you can mark the key as exportable if you would like. This means that you can take this with you and use it at a later date. Choose Next. Allow the default to select the certificate store and choose Next. Choose Finish on the last wizard screen. Now you should be able to open the document.